Hi, I'm Gary from Gary's Craft Room, and in this video I have Tonic Studio's Craft Kit number 21 for you. First I show you the products. There is a specialty card, a gorgeous glitter card and classic card, and the amazing texture papers are yummy, the wallet with the stamps and a stencil this time, the mixed media style dies with sentiments, and here are the sentiments with the mat cut out, and they can be used in three ways. A dual blender brush and gilding flakes, a hybrid ink cube embellishment mousse, and the first stone drops. And I know drop lovers will be hooked right away, as they are gorgeous. And the first Tonic Studio's washi tape. I am going to make a few cards, and I will show you different ways to add the gilding flakes, all in a mixed media distress style. First I color my paper with embellishment mousse and a sponge. I just add it in a circular motion. I use smooth white card, and this goes very fast. And the mousse will dry real quickly. I spray some water drops, as this will work best for this technique. And then I'm going to add clear embossing powder. I shake off the excess powder, and then I'm going to melt the powder. Depending on the stickiness of the embossing powder, it will hold the flakes, a little or a lot. This embossing powder needs some help, so heating it in parts and adding the flakes in the warm areas work best. I take a pinch of the flakes and rub it on the warm embossing parts. A word of warning, this is the most messy way to add the flakes. Don't point the heat tool at the flakes, as they will fly quite a distance, and stay clear of fans and air conditioning. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. You can also check out the products I used on my blog, where I added them with each card. I just keep heating parts and adding the flakes, and this will give a fun distressed look. I found the blender brush works well to brush off the excess flakes. And this is the mini and big gilding flakes jar, just to show you the cuteness of the mini, and I did another background the same way. I used the die to cut a panel and cut it out twice to extend the panel, and I taped that to the background. I cut another panel with the other die also twice, and taped that to the other background with the flakes. And I cut off the bits that are sticking out. I taped the background to a black note card to get a more masculine color scheme. And I'm going to finish with the sentiment. I used some of the colored paper with the mousse in the same color for the sentiment, and the black mat to make the colors match. And I do the same for the other card. I cut a frame and put that on top of the background and taped it to a black card. And I finish with the sentiment. And here is the gorgeous stone drop with lots of texture. I love it. The color dries a bit lighter than it shows in the bottle. I pre-made a bunch and let them dry a bit longer, as I made pretty big ones, and I glue them to the card using the same drops. And here are the finished cards. And now the second and less messy way to add the flakes. I cut the die out of craft cardstock, like I did for the first card. And I have a piece of pearlescent card and the Nuvo glue pen. I'm just going to fill the spaces with the glue pen. Just draw. Don't press on the pen, as more glue will come out and it may go under the template. And just fill the open spaces this way. So here you can see the glue on the card. I wipe off the glue right away with a wet wipe from this craft card that has a smooth side, so that will work, and I let it dry and I can use it again for another project. And I add the flakes again, taking a pinch from the top and rubbing it on the card. And I use the dual blending brush also to spread it, which works really great. And the last way to apply the flakes is also with a glue pen. Now I push on the pen to let some of the glue come out on a scrap piece of paper. And I apply it with a sponge and just bouncing on the card here and there. And this time there's no need to dry, as there is not so much glue on the card now. So I add the flakes right away, and this gives a fun distressed look. And then I add my card on top. I used a card I cut in the same way as the first cards, but this time I make it more feminine by using a white background. And for the last card, I distressed the edges of my card with my scissors. I use the side of the scissors, as this works even better than the blade that I normally do. And I'm going to make some layers with the blue classic card and the card with the flakes. I cut a strip of the blue floral lace paper and I tape that to a white mat to make it stand out more. I cut the strips to size and distress the edges again. And then I'm going to tape it to the card. I finish with white sentiments. I cut them twice and glue them together to get some extra dimension. And some navy blue drops to finish. The golden glacier card is smooth enough to add the drops on straight, but I would suggest to pre-make them as they flatten out a bit while drying. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting!